and welcome to another video on the lesson Periodic Classification of Elements. And today we are going to talk about in detail the position of different elements, metals, non-metals and metalloids. So before starting, I'd like to explain what is the meaning of metalloids. Metalloids are semi-metals because they have some properties of metals as well as non-metals. So if I give you a quick example of metalloid, it would be silicon. Okay, then eka silicon, germanium is also going to be a metalloid. Okay, so let's get started about the details in the position. And I will also try and explain why we have such a position, because science is all about whys and whats. Okay, so let's get started. First, we are going to try and look at the position of metals. Metals, as you all know, and you can see from the periodic table, are placed on the left side of the periodic table, like Na, that is sodium, Mg, magnesium, and so on. They are placed on the left side of the periodic table, while the non-metals are placed on the right side of the periodic table. Quick example, sulfur and chlorine. Then, in the middle, we have the metalloids or the semi-metals, which have the properties of both metals and non-metals. Silicon is the quickest example. So, here you will also find a very interesting phenomena that metals and non-metals are being distinguished by a curved line of metalloids. So, which are the metals that consist of this curved line? Let's start one by one and I will even tell you a magic formula to learn them. Okay, so it goes like boron. If you remember in Mendeleev, it was eka boron, eka aluminium and eka silicon. So eka boron, then we skip eka aluminium. As you all know, that aluminium is a metal. So eka boron, then comes our eka silicon. And what is eka silicon? It's germanium. Then after that we have AA and TP. AA is our arsenic, antimony. TP is our tellurium and polonium. So this is the curved line that consists of. So now we are going to talk in detail why are metals placed here and non-metals placed there. And before that, I want to tell you something additional. That is where are the placement of the placement of the noble gases. Noble gases, as you all know, have a complete octet and so are very inert and do not react with others, except some exceptions. So, why are they placed in the rightmost? It is because they have full octet, that is 8. And I have already told you that the total number of, for example, if in a period, the maximum shells that are being filled are L, or the maximum shells which are being filled are M. So, in L, the maximum number of elements are going to be 8. And in M, the maximum number of elements are going to be 18. So, we are going to see that the last element, the 18, has a full octet. The 8 has a full octet. So, that's why, and noble gases have a full octet. That's why they are placed in the rightmost part. Now, coming on to the metals. What are metals, first of all? Metals are electropositive. By electropositive, I mean that they lose their electrons to complete their octet. So, we can take a quick example of Na. It loses its electron to form NaCl, because Na gives 1, Cl takes 1, and we have NaCl. The beautiful combination. So, this is electropositive. And now we are going to see metallic character actually decreases as we go towards right in a period. Why does it happen? Because I have already told you, the effective nuclear charge increases. So if the effective nuclear charge will increase, then the ability to lose electrons will decrease. That is why the metallic character decreases as you go towards the right of the periodic table. Then, second thing, does it increases or decreases as you go from, up to down a group? It increases. It actually increases. Because new shells are being added, so the last or the outermost shell is more differentiated from the nucleus, and so it can lose electrons easily. Okay, so this was the metallic. Why are they placed there and all about the metallic character? Now put this aside and we are going to take up non-metallic. Non-metals are electronegatives. They actually gain electrons to form an octet. For example, chlorine, sulfur, and there are countless of many. So we have observed that the non-metallic character decreases as we go from right to left in a table. Why? Because effective nuclear charge decreases, and so they can lose their electron as we go towards the left. And it also decreases down a table. Why it decreases down a group? Because new shells are being added, and so the differentiated the outermost shell is most differentiated, and so it can lose easily. It cannot gain. So we are just talking about gain. That is why the non-metallic character decreases as we go down a group and decreases as we go right to left in a periodic table. Okay. So now you will be saying, we have a point. You said that as we go from down, as we go down a group, then the nuclear charge increases. But now you're saying nuclear charge does not increase. What are you saying? Now I'm talking about effective nuclear charge, not nuclear charge. Effective nuclear charge is a charge that is in, that is happening right there. But as new shells are being added, it's more differentiated, so effective nuclear charge decreases. Now, we know about the position of metals, non-metals. How can we, get the properties of elements from them? We know that oxides of non-metals are acidic in nature, while the oxides of metals are basic in nature. That's why we can determine the properties also. So I hope that this chapter is quite clear in your head. And if you want more about chemistry, physics, and the wonderful world of SST, then you've got to see my other videos as well. Thank you.